I met a lot of girls on Tinder, and that's a 50-50 shot. You're gonna have some escorts, some prostitutes that's on there looking for clients. You're gonna have some women on there trying to scam you, and there's a very small percentage of the women on there that actually, they are looking for a foreign guy. But my best advice is, if you do meet a girl on Tinder and you decide to meet, and don't let her pick the restaurant. You tell her, you make some plans. You see what's around, and you tell her, we're going here. I mean, because if she's telling you to go to a certain restaurant, it's likely that she's going to get a kickback.
Hi, welcome to today's live audition for Who Wants to Marry a Foreigner, reality TV pilot for the Bachelor number 2 selection. Okay, let's check out today's intro reel for today's Bachelor. All right, but before we get going, check out this insane story of an upcoming Bachelor contestant.
I was having tea in a Lviv cafe when a stranger asked me if he could join me. Being Canadian, I was happy to oblige him. But then the next thing I knew, I felt a strange kind of dizziness. When I suspected that my tea had been drugged, I got up to leave. Then out of nowhere, I was grabbed, thrown in a car, driven out into the dark snowy woods, assaulted, robbed, and left for dead in a field. If a Ukrainian Good Samaritan had not seen my snow-covered body, I wouldn't be alive today to tell you my story. I woke up in what looked like a war-torn Lviv hospital with doctors standing over me. My survival journey is another chapter. My name is Dennis Novoselsky, and I'm a Bachelor number 1 in the contest Who Wants to Marry a Foreigner.
All right, so subscribe to our channel now and smash the bell so you don't miss all the 37 exciting Bachelor editions coming to this YouTube channel soon. Here's the thing, if you smash the bell now, YouTube will notify you when we go live with the pilot to the reality TV show. So remember, guys, this contest closes in a few days, Wednesday, March 31st at midnight Pacific time. So you still have time to squeak in there and win this thing. So what are you waiting for? Go and enter to win now at matchguaranteed.com/register. Or you can click the registration link in the description below this video and enter right now. So what is it actually, what do you get? What do you win? Well, two lucky bachelors will win our coveted $10,000 lifetime matchmaking guarantee package, unlimited dating, and our team's full support until you walk down that aisle with your beautiful Ukrainian wife. So how are the winners going to be chosen? Well, that's pretty cool, actually, because our number 1 and number 2 bachelor winners will be chosen by you. You see, after 7 days to the minute, we'll record the total view count of each Bachelor contestant's audition video. And after all 37 spots are filled, the Bachelor contestant with the highest view count will win. Also, the network has asked for your help in another way. If you think today's Bachelor will be successful, give this video a thumbs up or a thumbs down if you think he's totally out of his league and is going to fail. Hit the thumbs again up or the thumbs down. Okay, without further ado, let's say hi to our Bachelor number 2, Corey. Hi, Corey. How are you doing today?
Oh, pretty good.
Good. So how Welcome to your audition for Who Wants to Marry a Foreigner. It's nice to meet you. How are you feeling today about your audition?
Pretty good.
Okay, good. Do you understand what this audition is all about?
Yeah, that's fine. Yes.
Okay. You're competing with 30 other bachelor spots and number two other bachelor contestants to win that spot to be aired on national TV in Who Wants to Marry a Foreigner reality TV pilot to be filmed this summer in 2021. So, Corey, how do you feel about do you have a good shot, at least better than Vegas, at winning our coveted $10,000 lifetime matchmaking guaranteed package?
Yeah, I think I've got good chances.
All right, great. Today we'll give you an expert feeling of what that journey might look like and let you take a look at the experiences of other guys that have been successful on this journey before you have.
Let me share a little bit more about my experience of working with Match Guaranty.
I was surprised. I was very inundated with the amount of ladies that I was going to meet. Very, very beautiful women.
So let's see. In total, I went on around, it was 10 first dates. They were all incredibly beautiful, so much more than their photos. Compared to back home, yeah, I'm definitely out of my league.
You know, don't be super cautious. Relax, especially trust Joe and Match Guaranty. And personally, I can put my stamp of approval.
Match Guaranty definitely delivered, I will say that. And I can't be happier really with the decision to go ahead and give it a try.
Joe and Match Guaranty made everything happen for me. And I couldn't be happier with where I'm at right now.
The expense of Match Guaranty is money well spent. It's a guarantee that you will meet women. It's a guarantee that you'll find somebody. And you'll also be able to do so in a very reasonable period of time.
Met some quality women, two of whom that I have a real connection with.
I've enjoyed it from, like I said, from start to finish. The girls seem like they're a lot more genuine. You can tell that the fraud or the fakeness that I've experienced in the past isn't there.
They've done a wonderful job for me. So far, I can close my eyes and I can tell Joe, find me a girl and I can trust that girl.
Match Guaranty is not a small investment, but it's a very good investment if you're really looking to find somebody.
Working with Match Guaranty is actually less cost, it's much more efficient, and you have a good process on the way where you actually will be successful in your search.
What did you pay, let's start Ash, for the unlimited matchmaking partnership? What did you pay?
$8,000 total.
And what do you say about that? Was it worth it?
So, first of all, to be honest with you, I didn't think it was real, so I had to come here first to meet you, know you're real or not. I came and met Joe, and I was impressed by him and Tatiana and Olga and the website and how organized and the connections with the ladies. So I had no hesitation whatsoever, and I'm glad to. It's worth it, and worth a lot more than that, yes.
What did you pay for the unlimited matchmaking partnership, and was it worth it?
So the investment was $8,000, but it was well worth it to find the right person that I can hopefully spend the rest of my life with, and I've got no real complaints, and I wouldn't hesitate to do it again.
Of course it's worth it. You're investing in yourself. You're not purchasing a car that you trade in the future or something frivolous. You're investing in your life, a life partner, as a matter of fact. So how can you say $8,000 investing in yourself isn't worth your entire life being happy with someone? Like, I came for 6 days. My very first date, we hit it off and have been like this ever since. So how can you not say that spending $8,000 for that kind of relationship in that short of time is not worth it?
If you're looking for a decent, honest company that will help you find the one, Match Guaranty is a perfect choice.
Very, very overwhelming experience to this point. I could not have asked for more. It's been a great, great experience.
I am utmost thankful and grateful to Joseph and his team for the counseling. Match Guaranty led me down the right path.
You're doing it for more than just the fees you received. You get, you know, you really want to help people.
So $8,000 may sound like a lot of money, but I can tell you that in my experience, the opportunity to meet a variety of different great women in just a little over a week's time and to establish something meaningful with a girl who has incredible model-like beauty as well as a lot of depth of character. She speaks four different languages. She's very intelligent and family-oriented. It's quite a bargain at that rate, as far as I'm concerned.
For me, the hardest part was looking past the beauty and actually finding someone who I want to marry and be with the rest of my life.
So at the end of the day, I couldn't be more happy with this investing in myself and my future.
Give Joe a chance, and you know, you'll be very happy, you'll be satisfied.
Match Guaranty is the real deal. Match Guaranty kicks ass.
Not knowing what it was, I will not give you up this time. Darling, just kiss me slow. Your heart is all I own. And in your eyes, between my arms, you look perfect tonight.
All right, now I'm going to ask you to take a walk down memory lane and share your past experiences looking for a wife in Ukraine, okay? Does that sound all right?
First trip to Ukraine was with a friend of mine in 2011. We went to Kiev and was supposed to meet a girl, and the schedules didn't, it just never happened. So we were supposed to stay in Kiev for about 4 or 5 days. We decided to leave. We took a train west to Lviv, and we stayed there for 12 hours waiting for the train to Poland. And we spent 2 days in Poland and then flew back to Prague and went home. That was my first trip in 2011. 2012, I came back by myself, but I actually made a round through Europe first. I went to France and Netherlands, and I did 5 days in Kiev and then the last 5 days in Odessa. And I did meet one girl in Kiev. We went to dinner once and it just never, it didn't go any further because she wanted to communicate through the website, and I was like, no, that sent the red flag, and I was like, no thanks. So that was that. And then I got to Odessa, and it's kind of a little bit of a disaster. I missed my plane, and I had to take a bus there, and it was interesting. But a friend of mine had a contact there. I got in touch with her, and she speaks perfect English. She's an English teacher. And she kind of helped me out. I found my apartment, and then the rest of the trip pretty good after that. And I didn't really, the girl I was scheduled to meet there, same thing, didn't get in touch with her. So I just kind of hung out on the Deribaska and went to Arcadia and went to see the sights, and that's about it. And then I've been going pretty much every summer since then. Sometimes I've been there 2018, 19 New Year's Eve, and the year before. Yeah, I did. Two New Year's Eves there. And then I kind of enjoyed that too, even though it wasn't summertime. Still had fun.
All right, so about 10 years you've been kind of going to Ukraine, it sounds like, so how much money in total have you spent searching for a wife in Ukraine? Can you give me a rough estimate?
I haven't been really looking that hard, because since I kind of lost faith in those agencies, so I figured I'm gonna go there and do it on my own. And I made a lot of friends there, so I haven't lost. I've gained. I got 10, 15 good friends in Ukraine now, so it's not a complete loss. But specifically just going just to meet the wife thing, that was probably the first two trips, and then after that, I was just going and enjoying myself. And if I meet somebody, I meet somebody. It wasn't the number one mission priority going there, just focus on looking for a wife. I was, and I got friends now from New Zealand, from England, from the Netherlands, because there's so many guys from all over to meet. And we usually try, like my closest inner circle, we try to schedule our vacations at the same time so we can hang out when we go there.
All right. So one question I'll ask is, what pond were you fishing in? What I mean by that is, which online dating sites were you using that you felt were scam sites, and then how much money were you scammed by each of those sites?
Well, that Anastasia one, my friend recommended that one because he had met a girl on there. And after my second trip, my contact in Odessa was a interpreter for Anastasia. So after I told her about I met some girl on the site, she told me, get off of the site. This probably not even the girl that you're writing that's getting the letters. You're writing a picture. So since then I don't even remember my login information. I don't really fool with the sites too much anymore.
Okay. So that's how you kind of figured out you were being scammed, or you mentioned before a red flag came when the lady didn't show up. Can you tell us
about that? I have no illusions that I'm some kind of, a perfect 10. And I'd get 15 to 20 letters a day from these women. I'm like, I got a lot of common sense. It don't seem right. So if it don't seem right, it usually not right.
Yeah.
So I just kind of went with the feeling. Now I don't trust it.
So you've been to Ukraine multiple times. So what are the top three lessons you learned and you'd like to share with guys to help them see the light and avoid the painful mistakes others have made by some of these PPL sites, and that you made with Anastasia?
Don't use those sites at all. And if you do, I met a lot of girls on Tinder, and that's a 50-50 shot. You're gonna have some escorts, some prostitutes that's on there looking for clients. You're gonna have some women on there trying to scam you, and there's a very small percentage of the women on there that actually, they are looking for a foreign guy. But my best advice is, if you do meet a girl on Tinder and you decide to meet, and don't let her pick the restaurant. You tell her, you make some plans, you see what's around, and you tell her, we're going here. I mean, because if she's telling you to go to a certain restaurant, it's likely that she's going to get a kickback. Yeah, I've seen that go down. Hanging out at a couple of different, some of these restaurants that I went eat with locals that I know, and we sitting at a table, and we could see stuff going on at tables, and we could tell these guys are they're about to get got.
Yeah.
Throw the order and all kinds of stuff, and we're giggling and laughing, and my friends, she can hear the conversation, and the girls they're talking to the guys, and then they're laughing about stuff after in Russian, and the guys can't understand. So,
yeah. All right. Well, let's take a deep breath now and breathe out the bad and in with the good. Are you ready to change that bad story into a good story with a happy ending?
Yeah. Well, I was wanting to do it on my own, but I'm leaving all options open. So.
Okay.
You know, well, this seems to be a legitimate, organization. So mm-hmm. He seems trustworthy.
Yes. Well, we're going to give you an honest assessment of how good your real chances are of finding what you want. My promises to you is to give you my honest evaluation, even though it sometimes with some clients, it takes some tough love. Does that sound fair?
Well, yeah, I kind of like constructive criticism. I don't like anybody sugarcoating. If I'm doing something that's not right, go ahead and tell me. I'm not gonna cry about it. I'm like, well, thank you, appreciate it.
All right. So, Corey, why Ukraine? What? Why did you think maybe I can meet someone in Ukraine?
Well, it actually wasn't my idea. It was my buddy. He met one on the website, and he talked me into going. So, the guy that originally talked me into going, he backed out at the last minute. I went with somebody else.
All right.
But it was him. And then when I went there, the first trip really didn't sell me on Ukraine. It's my second trip when I made a few friends in Odessa that I love the place. I'm wanting maybe to possibly retire there. Mm-hmm. So, if I'm going to retire in Ukraine, it's probably best to have a Ukrainian wife.
All right, yeah. So why do you think you weren't successful in finding a wife in the United States?
Well, it's not all their fault. It's some of my fault. I'm 43. I'm kind of hard-headed. I'm a little impatient. And Louisiana women are kind of crazy. So.
All right, fair enough. What specifically are you looking for in a future wife?
It has the stuff together. I mean, it's not kind of organized. Mm-hmm. Knows what she wants. Not changing her mind every 5 minutes. Okay. Got a little ambition.
Okay, that sounds good. So you've tried our free 10 lady introductory test drive. You've already chosen those 10 ladies from our unlimited database. You've written your introductory letter, send us your best picks, and now you're waiting to hear back from your ladies. Is that correct?
Yeah.
Okay. Are you excited to see which ladies will say yes?
Yeah, I'm kind of curious to see see how I did.
Okay. So out of 10, how many yeses do you think you'll get?
I'm pretty confident, so I would say probably six right. out of 10.
Okay. Do you think these ladies are realistic for you? And if so, why?
Yeah, I didn't pick women 20 years younger than me. I mean, even though a 25-year-old Ukrainian woman is probably 35 American years as far as like maturity level, but still, I'm 43, so I wouldn't want any woman under maybe 31. I mean, if she was younger than 31, she'd have to really have her stuff together and, for me to actually go that much younger.
Okay. So let me be blunt about you. Do you think these ladies would be out of your league back home, or do you think you're pretty realistic about you'd be dating the same about ladies as at home?
Well, at this point, they'd be a couple points ahead of me. But when I was younger, I was a few pounds lighter, and I did pretty good.
All right. Okay. Well, next we'll
I didn't pick any really good ones because I'd probably be married. I was, after a while.
Yeah, that sounds fine. So next we're going to talk about your zone of success. Now, our zone of success evaluation was created by Joe and Tatiana by reverse engineering how and why hundreds of married couples were successful. Zone of success is broken down into five parameters that will most definitely determine your success or failure in the real world of matchmaking with our Ukrainian ladies. Does that sound good?
Yeah.
Okay, zone of success, the first thing is age gap. So for us, again, we try to have people stay within 10 years, but it can be realistic up to 15 years from your age. It looked like with all the ladies, you did that. So good job with that. I believe that with that function, you will find some success there. Number two. It's financial stability. What's your total annual income?
Well, it ranges anywhere from depending on how much side work I do. Mm-hmm. My base salary at work is probably, that's my offshore job, around $80,000. And I probably do anywhere from 20 to 40,000 in side work, and I don't want to count my rental income because right now all my rental income is flipped back into my rentals. I don't touch into that until I got a partner in that. I got my stepdad. Me and him invest together. Once we get the amount of rentals we want, then we're gonna actually start drawing off of that, and that's gonna be, we should be finished in about the next year or two. Mm-hmm. That's going to be an extra $50,000 coming in. So I would say I'm around, you average it, say around 150.
All right. So do you own your own home?
Well, I own several homes. So right now I'm kind of staying in one of the rentals, and I don't really build the house until, cause I mean, if I'm going to get married, woman needs to have a little feedback on that. Uh-huh. So, I mean, I got places to stay. That's not a problem. But I actually build a house, which I could, I mean, I got good credit and I could do it anytime I really want. I own property. I got empty lots. So, I have it. Well, yeah.
Okay. Why we ask that is just pretty much the number one thing for Ukrainian ladies is that security and safety aspect. So they're looking for someone that can take care of them. And in Ukraine, home ownership is something that a lot of them have. And then renting is very risky over there. You can get kicked out, in one day's notice. So it's one of those things where ladies, when they find out if you have a house or you know, some houses, at least that they feel a lot more secure with.
I've got about 10 right now. So.
I'm
good. Yeah, I'm good on that level.
Okay. So are you okay with dating single moms?
Up to two kids. No, I'd be happy.
Okay.
Two.
Why we ask that again is as far as your zone of success, if you are open to dating single moms, again, that just widens your chances out, as a lot of single moms are just unable to find a husband over there. So it's just something that's out there that just will widen your success if you're okay with that. Do you want to have children with the Ukrainian lady?
Of my own, I'm 43. I would probably almost rather have a woman that already had 1 to 2 children. Okay. Because I think I'm kind of past my prime in that. I don't know if I want to have a kid at this age.
Okay.
So that's why, I'd almost probably prefer a single mom with 1 or 2 kids.
All right, that's good. Why we ask that is a lot of single ladies between 30 and 40, that's something that they are looking for. If they don't have children, it's very important to the Ukrainian ladies to try to have children or have a child. So again, that's something that will increase or decrease your zone of success with that. So just going over that. And then how often can you come to Ukraine?
Well, depending, I work 14 and 14, so I can actually come to Ukraine 3-4 times a year.
Yeah. Okay. Then you know, your assessment is you can do real well. I think you would be successful finding a wife in Ukraine, just because you've gone through most of the parameters and you're open on it, and I think you would be able to find someone good, because again, we ask guys when they are with us to be open to at least coming to Ukraine 2-3 times, because no one's going to meet and really marry someone after just one visit. It's you need to nurture that relationship and all that.
I wouldn't even try. That's not no. You can't get to know somebody in 2 weeks.
All right. Yeah. So thanks again, Corey, for that. And thanks for your audition today. I wish you luck in winning the Bachelor number 2 spot in Who Wants to Marry a Foreigner reality TV show. So next we'll see you on YouTube. Okay.
Thank you.
Have you been searching for a beautiful wife? Do you dream of meeting the perfect woman, but haven't found her? Well, imagine if there was a simple way this could all change for you. Imagine if there was a Canadian marriage agency that would introduce you to as many beautiful women as it takes until you find the one. Ukraine, a lost world of beautiful traditional women. At last, a place where you can find the beautiful wife you have always dreamed of. Every Ukrainian woman dreams of having a happy family. Now you can have a traditional beautiful wife from Ukraine, creating happy family memories forever. So what are you waiting for? Register right now and Skype our beautiful ladies completely free. So what makes us different, you might ask? Why not ask Google simply by searching Match Guaranty Reviews?